Number 1. The Galactic Phantom. At first glance, nothing about the Oort cloud is out of the ordinary. It's a big patch of icy space that tosses out comet every now and then, giving us occasional air shows from celebrities like Halley's Comet. We have a pretty good idea of what it's made of, how big it is, and when it was formed, but nobody has ever seen it. And we aren't totally sure that it exists. It only exists in theory. As of right now, it's our only real explanation for the comets that seem to come out of nowhere, since their orbits show that they must have originated from a region beyond the Kuiper Belt. On top of that, many computer models of the solar system's formation predict that the gas and ice giants would have scattered an enormous amount of icy planetesimals outwards in the system's early days. This would have ejected most of them from the system, but some would have remained attached to the Sun and fallen into orbits thousands of times more distant than those of the modern Kuiper Belt in the form of the Oort cloud. The Oort cloud theoretically lies up to 100,000 astronomical units from the Sun, an astronomical unit being about 93 million miles. This means that Oort cloud is a fifth of the way to the nearest star, so far away that the objects within it have never been seen and still remain mystery to this day. Number 2. Tabby Star. NASA's Kepler Space Telescope was designed to search for extrasolar planets by measuring dips in a star's brightness as orbiting planets move across the stellar disk. Kepler stares at more than 150,000 stars towards the constellation of Cygnus and Lyrae, and so far has discovered over 5,000 exoplanet candidates. But the telescope also monitors the light fluctuations in all the other stars, even dips not caused by transits, and has found some bizarre situations. The strangest is the case of KIC 8462852, also known as Tabby Star, a main-sequence F-type star located in the constellation Cygnus, approximately 1480 light-years away. The timing and duration of diminished light flux episodes Kepler detected coming from this star are a mystery. These dimming events vary in magnitude and don't occur at regular intervals, making an orbiting planet an unlikely explanation. Every now and then, at random intervals, KIC displayed extremely unusual dimming patterns. Something was blocking out a huge portion of its light at irregular intervals. For reference, a planet like Jupiter blocks around 1% of light from the Sun. Something passing by KIC, however, was at times blocking about 20% of the light. What is causing this is not known. But one of the theories about KIC is that its bizarre dimming was the result of a family of comets swarming the star. But this cannot be the case, as scientists went through Harvard's historical records and found the dimming has been taking place for over a century. This makes the comet theory implausible. To have this level of dimming, you would need 648,000 giant comets, each having 200 kilometers of diameter, all to all pass the star within the last century. Some have suggested it's a Dyson swarm, a less complete version of megastructure known as the Dyson sphere, which surrounds a star and harvests its energy output. We'll probably get a better idea of what's going on with the star when NASA launches the James Webb Space Telescope in 2018. But until then, unknown alien megastructure sounds like a pretty cool explanation. Number 3. Planet HD 106906b. Astronomers have discovered an exoplanet that is unlike anything in our own solar system. HD 106906b has 11 times the mass of Jupiter and orbits its star at 650 times the average Earth-Sun distance. The incredibly lonely Neptune, our most distant planet, lumbers around the Sun at only 30 Earth-Sun distance. This is already an amazing range, but HD is so far separated from its parent that Neptune and the Sun are comparatively within hugging distance. This huge discrepancy is responsible for the addition of many asterisks above our planetary formation theories, as astronomers scramble to explain HD's existence in spite of its vast orbit and heft. For example, the forces responsible for making planets are usually undone by such great distances, raising the possibility that HD was created by the collapse of a debris ring. Yet, HD is too massive for that to happen, and the primordial disks of raw matter that can birth planets simply do not contain enough stuff to produce giants like HD. The mystery as to how such a huge planet formed at such great distance still remains. Number 4. Biggest object in the solar system. Representing 99% of the mass in the solar system, the Sun is the largest object by far. However, in 2007, for just a brief period, a comet actually became larger than the Sun. Okay, it really wasn't the comet itself that grew, but the coma, the nebulous region surrounding the comet made out of ice and dust. 17P Holmes was discovered in 1892 by its namesake, astronomer Edwin Holmes. Since then, we've tried to keep an eye on it despite losing it for 60 years between 1906 and 1964. It is not uncommon for a comet to experience an outburst in brightness. But on October 23, 2007, Comet Holmes unexpectedly underwent a change in brightness by a factor of 500,000. It was the biggest comet outburst ever recorded, noticeable to the naked eye. Over the next month, the coma kept expanding until it reached its peak at a diameter of 1.4 million kilometers, officially becoming larger than the Sun. As of now, we still don't know exactly why this outburst happened. Number 5. The oldest quasar. Perhaps one of the most perplexing mysteries in current astrophysics is the science behind quasars. Quasars are extremely distant objects in our known universe. They are the furthest objects away from our galaxy that can be seen. Quasar stands for quasi-stellar object. This was because when they were first optically detected, they looked like bluish stars. They are believed to be supermassive black holes at the center of distant galaxies. Now, such black holes are thought to exist at the center of most galaxies. However, what sets a quasar apart from a normal galaxy is how the material is falling into the black hole. Because of the conservation of angular momentum, the material can't just fall straight into the black hole. Rather, it falls into orbit around it. This material forms a disk, called an accretion disk. When a galaxy, star, or gas is absorbed into quasar in such a way, the result is a massive collision of matter that causes a gigantic explosive output of radiation energy and light. This great burst of energy results in a flare or jets of energy, which is a distinct characteristic of quasars. These jets could be as long as 150 light years, and its temperatures could be more than 150 times that of the Sun. The disk around the quasars is the size of the solar system. However, it emits radio waves and visible light up to 100 times the luminosity of the entire Milky Way galaxy. Since quasars are so distant, the only way we can monitor them is by measuring the spectrum of their light. Since they have the largest redshift of any known object in the cosmos, due to the effect of the expansion of the universe, astronomers are able to observe their redshift to measure their speed and distance. The greater the redshift, the farther the object is, and the faster it is moving away from us. It is believed that some quasars are traveling through space at 240,000 kilometers per second. That's nearly 80% of the speed of light. At 2 billion solar masses, ULAS J1120 plus 0641 was a huge surprise for astronomers, not necessarily due to its magnitude, but due to its age. ULAS is the oldest quasar ever found. It appeared less than 800 million years after the Big Bang. That's absolutely ancient, and it means that the light from the distant quasar had been on a 12.9 billion year intergalactic voyage before it arrived here on Earth. No one is sure why the black hole is so big, since there wasn't much of anything for it to eat that long ago. Quasars sparked a debate amongst the astrophysics community when it was suggested that quasars are distant points in the universe where new matter is entering our universe, which would make them the polar opposite of a black hole. It may be years before we actually know the purpose of these bright, beautiful celestial objects, but they sure are something to look at, sometimes outshining the galaxy they are contained in.